Hello, I'm Richard Armstrong, and I'm going to talk a bit about the incorporation of pricing data into the NJR. So you may have heard of an initiative called NJR Price Benchmarking, also called NJR Embed. So I want to tell you a bit about it and show you how you can access this data. So Embed is the NJR implant price benchmarking service, and it's been incorporated into the NJR in line with one of the NJR's original strategic objectives, actually, which was to look at supporting cost effectiveness in joint replacement surgery. And in order to do that, the NJR needed also to understand the cost of implants, and so it embarked on a program to collect that data and to present it back to hospitals and to surgeons in hopefully a meaningful way. So the purpose of the Embed service is very much to collect and feedback that data, and in providing that cost data, also providing it in a clinical context that's captured in the NJR. Embed sits very neatly alongside the work of GERFT and the Model Hospital Programme in providing the data back to surgeons and back to hospitals in a national context, allowing benchmarking. And importantly, Embed is now included as part of the NJR subscription, so any surgeon that has practice in the NHS in England or Wales will have access to all of this data as part of the NJR subscription from that trust. And why this data is included in the NJR is because its ability to provide the implant pricing in the clinical context is captured within the NJR. So I think it's widely recognised there's variation in costs of implants, but understanding the clinical context in which those implants were used is important when trying to understand why that variation exists. So with the NJR, we're able to link the implants used to the type of procedure that they're used in, to the surgeon, and understanding a bit of the clinical data that sits around the procedure that they're used within. So it's not just about costs and variation in costs, it's understanding the context of those costs based upon the procedures recorded in the registry. So just to walk through some of the mechanics, it's a very simple process for your hospital to get involved in this process. There is a pricing template that the NJR has developed that can be submitted to the registry, normally by somebody in finance or procurement, who understands the costs, the prices, as provided by the manufacturer. Those prices are uploaded into the registry and are then associated with the procedures from that hospital, from the surgeons, and fed back to the hospital and to the surgeons in a set of reports that I'll show you shortly. Trusts can then refresh those prices at any time, so having uploaded the prices once, if there's then a renegotiation back with their supplier, there's an opportunity to refresh those prices at any point in time. And the data that we have now represents 80 trusts, so more than half of the trusts have submitted prices, which gives us a reasonable picture, actually. And finally, just to add to that, we've recently engaged with NHS Improvement and around the work that they've been doing in this space, which is an initiative called the Purchase Price Index Benchmarking System, which has been collecting pricing data from across the NHS, not just orthopaedics, but a wide range of categories. And through that agreement with them, we can now bring in prices from all of the other trusts. So very shortly, we'll have a complete picture of implant costs from across England. And in calculating the analysis that forms the Embed service, we also have a concept of a fully costed procedure. So we're looking at not just the price of a particular implant, but the costs of implants used in a total procedure. And in so doing, clearly we need to ensure that we've got a representative set of implants used in the procedure. So for example, in a hip procedure, we're making sure there's a stem, a head, a cup and a line, etc. One of the areas of interest in this is cement and accessories. These can be included or excluded in the analysis, as I will show you. In the reports that we provide back to the trust, very clearly presents the completeness of the data. Obviously, it's important to look at how good the data is that we're reporting on. So within the reports you can see the extent to which we're able to cost up all the procedures for any particular trust. So the embed report for hospitals comes back through the NJR management feedback system. Every hospital that submits data to the NJR to the registry will have access to this, and there's an embed report for every organisation available through the management feedback system. There is also an embed report for surgeons available through the clinician feedback system. We can show you that at the back here. But just for your information, on the menu within the NJR, there's an implant pricing option, and you can see embed sits within there. So every surgeon can log in, click to download, and there's a full set of reports and analysis that sits within the NJR feedback system. Not every trust will have access to it, so there's some conditions around having to make payments and obviously also having to have uploaded the pricing data. If the event report's missing, contact us and we can ensure that you point them in the right direction. So some of the things that come out of price benchmarking, it allows us to look nationally at what the picture represents and also locally. So we can start to look, for example, at the costs of different types of procedures. These are the all of the implants used in cemented, cementless and hybrid procedures. You can see these are national pictures looking at the median, mean, minimum and maximum prices of implants used in those types of procedures. So I guess no surprise to see cemented procedures being the lowest, hybrid in the middle and cementless at the top. But we can also look at that by bearing surface as well, so we can look at costs of metal and poly, ceramic and poly, ceramic and ceramic, and look at the distribution of those costs. And again, this is a national picture, but it also provides access to this at a trust level. Similar with knees, again providing a view of the average costs of implants used in total and human knees. I guess more importantly for the trusts, it gives them a perspective as to where they sit within this context. So each trust gets a pack of data that shows where their average cost sits within that spectrum and where the range of costs sit within that spectrum for each trust. We also provide the actual itemised detail of which implants have been used, what the cost for the trust is, what the average cost that we see nationally is, and also what the best quartile cost is. So this is looking at an implant by implant level basis and potentially identifying some cost opportunities that may have to be considered locally. The embed report includes some analysis around hip fixation, for example, again giving the trust a view of its data versus the national picture. Use of ceramics clearly is a cost driver, and so the embed service gives a trust a perspective of use of ceramics in hip procedures within its organisation versus national picture, and stratifies that across age of patients. And similarly, just a total cost of implants used in different procedures across age stratified groups of patients. And then finally, it also provides, so at a trust level, an anonymised analysis of implant costs by surgeon. Each of those surgeons in their own data pack will have access to their own data, but at the hospital level, it's anonymised, as you can see. So really the key message is, if you haven't done so, do look at clinician feedback and do look at this data. It is available to everybody. If your trust hasn't engaged and loaded the data, please contact us and we can talk you through doing so. But really the purpose today is just to make people aware this is available and to use the service. Happy to take any questions. Thank you very much.
So, the other thing is that 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 the other thing